London-based Financial Times inks a content deal with OpenAI that will integrate the news outlet with ChatGPT. The contract allows select content from the Financial Times to appear in the chatbot's responses to relevant queries. Financial Times Group CEO John Ridding said the deal recognizes the value of award-winning journalism and will give insights on how content surfaces through AI. Now, OpenAI has struck a series of content licensing agreements as it aims to enrich ChatGPT's knowledge base with trustworthy sources. Philippine inflation in April expected to range from 3.5 to 4.3%. Now, this forecast is from the Philippine Central Bank. And if the upper end of its projection holds up, inflation in the month would be higher than the government's 2 to 4% inflation target for the year. The Banco Central points to the continued price increases in rice and meat and the weakening of the peso for the projection. After slowing to 2.8% in January, inflation again quickened to 3.4% in February and 3.7% in March amid high fuel and food prices, particularly rice. The Philippine Health Department going after government doctors who may be involved in an alleged marketing scheme with a pharmaceutical company. Health Secretary Ted Herbosa says the agency is looking into allegations, then they fully support the Senate probe on the issue. If government doctors were proven to be involved in the scheme, penalties may range from suspension to revocation of licenses.
This company has given, they have violated the Mexico principle. If they have given them to doctors in the same, that hospital, which is a government hospital, they also have violated the Graft and Corrupt Practices Act for public health officials because they are government doctors. So even if they did it in their private practice, but they did it in a government institution, I can go after these doctors and sue them in the ombudsman.
Herbosa also reminds the public doctors are required to put the generic names of medicines in their prescriptions.
All doctors, by law, should be prescribing the generic name. Underneath, the doctor can prescribe his preferred brand, in parentheses. If the doctor doesn't write the generic name, that is a violation of the generics law, and I think you can file a complaint against that doctor. Uh-oh. The patient is free to choose, because that means the FDA also approved that generic drug without the preference of the doctor. Uh-oh.
Belkens Pharma has been named as the company which is said to be giving huge commissions to doctors prescribing their medicines to patients. The company, though, denies what it called misinformed and unfounded allegations. The Philippine military confirms the Chinese ship seen roaming in the country's eastern seaboard is a research vessel. The Chinese flagship Shen Kuo passed through Batanes last week. It was last seen loitering the waters of Catanduanes over the weekend, ignoring radio challenges by Philippine authorities.
There was a lot of radio challenges that was already issued to the said vehicles for a couple of days. It is said that there were no personnel that were on the main deck, and there was also no response in terms of the challenges that were made.
A group of delivery riders urging the Marcos administration to address the High Commission being taken from them by delivery platforms. The Coalition of Couriers and Shipping Services says they have reached out to government agencies and the Philippine Congress regarding the issue, but no action has been taken so far. The group, along with the Lala Move Drivers Association, will hold a nationwide strike tomorrow on Labor Day to protest this matter.
May shipping fee ka ng 100, delivery fee, halimbawa po, 100 pesos, 20 pesos po yung kanila, 20% po. Sana 10% lang sir yung kanila eh. Nananawagan na po kami, halos 1 year na po eh. Tapos sabi po ng DICT, aayusin daw po at ipapatawag, pero hanggang ngayon sir, mag-iisang taon na, wala pa rin eh.